Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who's one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff uses the sculpting tools to precisely adjust how the eyebrow area deforms.
So once you've gone through all of your regions and adjusted your curves and strengths, I usually go through and make a pass on sculpting. And you don't have to sculpt every region. In fact, I usually only do a few specific sculpts, and the rest is kind of just as needed. Like, for instance, you don't usually need any kind of sculpting operation on the forehead, because it kind of works just fine by itself. Sometimes you might want to do a little sculpting on, like, the corrugators, because that stuff can get a little hard to manage with just wrinkle maps and enveloping. So if you wanted to kind of fine-tune the way that this wrinkles in the middle, you could do a sculpt for that, and I'll show you how to do that. So position your controllers in the pose that you want. And the way sculpting works is if you hit, you can see there's different types. There's skin, puffing, tendon, eyelid, and mouth. It's pretty self-explanatory. Anything that's not an eyelid or a mouth or a tendon or a puffer is skin. So the corrugators would be a skin sculpt. And when you hit this button, it looks for any controller that's not at zero and assumes, okay, that region is being stressed, and I'll give you a patch of geometry to sculpt there. So you'll make sure everything is at zero except the stuff that you want to work on. And I tend to work in symmetry like this. I'll do both sides at once just because it's easier to use symmetry mode to model both sides. So just as an example, we'll pose those corrugators like that and hit skin sculpt. And it initializes and gives you a patch of geometry to work on. So it found that that area was being used and gives you those verts. And then it's just, you know, tweak mode. Hit M and you have your standard set of tools for modeling. Proportional symmetry, kind of standard XSI modeling tools. So let's just do a quick adjustment here. Okay, well, let's say that's what you wanted. And you're happy with your sculpt. You just hit apply. And this will kind of bake that goal into the solver for those controls. And so now that is where those controls will drive that mesh. So you get a really huge amount of control over the exact shape of things that way.